How are y'all? It's me, it's Lavasia Rivers. And Lord, look at me, honey. Can you just tell I'm windblown as I can be? Reason I am is because I've been outside. I've been outside shopping for Mother's Day. I've been up to the greenhouse to buy my mother some flowers that she could stick in the dirt because it's something that she enjoys. So I want to take some time and I want to talk about the major national holiday that is this weekend coming up. I'm not talking about National Tater Tot Day, and I'm not talking about the Little League baseball game that your kids are going to play that they don't even understand what they're playing, and you're going to yell about it and sell some concessions and then go home and probably change clothes and go to the Mexican place. But after you go to that Mexican place on Saturday, I want you to think about Sunday, what you're going to do for your mom, okay? First of all, some of your moms go to Church House, so you need to get yourselves up, get pretty, and go to Church House with her. Fill her pew, let her win the award, honey, for having the most hoodlums in the Church House on your behalf. Because you know what? She brought you in this world, and she can always still take you out of this world. God knows I've heard that many times from my precious, beloved mother. Listen, don't go by the Food City last minute and pick her up some $38 bud vase that she's going to sling out as soon as you leave either, okay? Buy her something nice. Get her a gift card from QVC so she can get some of this hair pieces so she can wear her hair different ways. See, look, mom feels prettier and better already, and it was just from changing her hair. Just look, it's that simple. That's what you can do for your mother with a QVC gift card. Also, you know what? If she doesn't like QVC, get her a Home Shopping Club gift card. It's lesser stuff, but she might like lesser stuff. Some mothers are still tacky. They can't help it. We love them, but they can still be tacky. Don't also expect her to make you a big kettle of something to eat for dinner. You take her somewhere to eat. Whether it be that Bellasina's in Grundy, or honey, up under the where it used to be the Rainbow, that's now some Italian place that's not really that good that we all complain about, but still, you're taking your mother out for Mother's Day. Also, listen, it's very dated to get her that flower that you wear here on the shoulder. Get her a nice wristlet corsage. Get her something pretty, okay? Get it from Jury. Jury's Flowerland is back open again, honey, and he's serving things up right below Grundy. So you go down there and you see Jury and tell him that Lavasia sent you and tell him to not put any of that god-awful baby's breath in nothing that he makes. Anyways, I digress. Listen, if you're good to your mother, she'll be good to your children. And honey, if she's good to your children, that means you and your man can sneak off and go down there to that Margaritaville Hotel in Pigeon Forge and have you a romantic weekend and leave them hoodlum youngins off at your mother's. Also, you know what? You might have a pageant dress you need to pay for or some cleats in the fall, and you might not have money to pay for that. Your mama does because she's getting her Social Security and she's been saving money in a JFG coffee can for a long time. So you need to remember that. Be good to her and she'll be good to you. Make sure that you wish the other women in your life a happy Mother's Day, because there's a lot of wonderful mothers out there that's done a lot for us, honey. So think about all of the foremothers, not the forefathers, but the foremothers, as we plan and go into this weekend. And try to look as good as me the entire weekend and every other day. If you can't, well, God bless you anyhow. And happy Mother's Day, y'all.